Hello students, welcome back to History Adulan. Today we are going to begin with new lesson from Environmental Studies 5th Standard, Seeds and Seeds. To begin, let us begin with a short story of Gopal. Gopal was waiting for his mouse's family to visit them. They will be coming the next day for their holidays. He was thinking about all the fun and nice food that he would have with his cousins. Just then, his mother called out, "Gopal, before you sleep, remember to soak 2 small bowls, katoris of chana gram." She was going to his bua's house and would return only in the morning. As he was soaking the chana, Gopal thought, "How will 2 small bowls of these be enough for 8 persons? So he soaked another 2 bowls of chana. When his mother returned the next morning, she saw that the chana were overflowing from the vessel. "How much did you soak?" asked his mother. "How did that happen?" wondered Gopal. "You soak too much. Anyway, it is good. Now I will cook half of them and leave the other half to sprout." That's the story of Gopal. Now, why soaking chana or a gram in a water is required before cooking? Because these things are generally soaked in water. And what are the other things that are soaked in the water? Like nuts, rice, gram, pulses, almond, raisins and others. If we keep soaked seeds in a warm place for a day or two, we see some thread-like structures coming out of the seeds. Do you know what we call to it? Yes, they are sprouts. When seeds get moisture and warmth, the embryo uses the stored food in the cotyledon to grow into a sprout or baby plant or seedling. This process is called sprouting. Now let's work practically. Take some chana and 3 bowls. Put 5 chana in the first bowl and fill it up with water. Put a damp piece of cloth or same cotton wool in the second bowl. Now keep the same number of chanas in it. Make sure that the cotton wool or the cloth remain wet. Put the same number of chanas in the third bowl. Do not put anything else in it. Cover all the 3 bowls. Now let's have some observations after 2 days and note down the changes in the bowl. So here is your chart: bowl 1, bowl 2 and bowl 3. Are the seeds getting air? In bowl 1, no, because it is fully water packed. In bowl 2, yes. In bowl 3, also yes. Are the seeds getting water? In bowl 1, yes. In bowl 2, little from the damp cloth. And bowl 3, no. What changes did you see? In bowl 1, we see the growth of thread-like structure. In bowl 2 also, there is a growth of thread-like structure from the seeds, but its growth is less. And bowl 3, no change. Next question: have the seeds sprouted? Bowl 1, yes. Bowl 2, yes. But bowl 3, no. Now, why there is a growth of a thread-like structure or sprouts in bowl 1 and bowl 2, while there is no growth in the bowl 3? The reason is simple, because for the growth of any seed, it required moisture, warmth and air. Now, you can also work out on a simple project. Plant your seeds. Take a clay pot or a tin can with a wide mouth. Make a small hole at the bottom of the can. Fill your can with soil. Put 4 or 5 seeds of the same kind in the soil and press them gently. After a few days, seeds will sprout. This process of growth of a baby plant or embryo from the seed is called germination. All plants grow from a seed. Some plants can also grow without seed, and that is called grafting. The important factors for the growth of plant are soil, water, air, and sunlight. A sprouted seed grow into a plumule, that is called shoot, and down part is a radical, which is also called root. Now, how to select best seeds for germination? We can have a simple experiment. Heavy seeds that sinks in water bowl is best for germination, while seeds that floats may be not good for germination. Seed is the most important for growth of any plant or a tree. But what is that makes any plant to grow? What is inside a seed? Actually, seed have a baby plant called embryo. This embryo is further divided into two parts, plumule, which is also called shoot, which grows further outside the soil, and radical is the root, which grows under the soil. It is protected by a seed coat, and cotyledon stores food for embryo or baby plant. We also called it seedling. If you remember in the above Gopal story, that his mother told half of the sprouted chana she will be giving it to her aunt, because doctor suggested her to eat sprouted seeds. Now, why only seeds are recommended by the doctor to her aunt? Because sprouts are rich in vitamins and minerals, since doctors suggest most of the patients to eat sprouts. Now, let's understand some of the health benefits of sprouts. It helps in better digestion. It boosts our metabolism and immune power. It helps shed fat. It prevents anemia and cancer. Would you like to give a surprise to your parents? Then let's have one fun in the kitchen. Take some gram or mug seeds, maybe 1 cup, and develop into sprouts. And once they develop into sprout, serve your parents and family members. To add more taste, you may add jaggery to it. Your parents will be so happy to see you preparing and serving them sprouts. Wow, what a wonderful forest. So much variety of trees and plants here. These plants, small or big, grow from a tiny or a little seed. Let's find out some of the facts of the trees around the world. Redwood is said to be the largest tree in the world. It is in California and its height is 115 meters. There is a desert oak found in Australian deserts. Its age is recorded to be more than 1,000 years old. Even the peepal tree in India, which is famous for emitting maximum amount of oxygen. Then, there are some interesting facts about the different trees, like the plants which hunt. It's quite surprising to hear plant which hunt. Yes, there are some plants which trap and eat frogs, insects, and even mice. The pitcher plant or Nepenthes is one such plant. It is found in Australia, Indonesia, and Meghalaya in India. It has a pitcher-like shape and the mouth is covered by a leaf. The plant has a special smell that attracts insects to it. When the insects land on the mouth of the plant, it gets trapped and cannot get out. What a clever way to hunt. That's the hunting plant or pitcher plant. Plants cannot move around. Once they grow, they remain in the same place. But their seeds are great travelers. They can reach far and wide. Look at this picture. Have you ever seen any seeds that can fly? What is it called in your area? Yes, there are some seeds that is It carries with the help of wind, and they are cotton, we call in local language kapus, or also some people called it mahatari or the old woman. Same time, there are some seeds that cannot fly, but it can still travel by sticking onto the fur of animals or on others' cloths. In this way, it gets a free ride. Did you get any idea from these seeds? Now, listen, the idea of Velcro came to George Mestral. This happened in 1948. One day, George Mestral came back from a walk with his dog. He was amazed to find seeds sticking all over his clothes and on the dog's fur. He wondered what made them stick. So, he observed these seeds under a microscope. He saw that the seeds had many tiny hooks which got stuck to cloths or fur. This gave Mestral the idea of making Velcro. He made a material with similar tiny hooks that could stick. Velcro is used to stick together many things: cloths, shoes, bags, belts, and many more. What a way to take inspiration from nature, isn't it? Some seeds reach far and wide with the help of air, water, birds, animal, human, etc. Look at this picture and guess how seeds travels from one place to another. Some plants spread their seeds over a long distances. When a soybean pods are ripe, they burst and seeds are thrown out. Now, just think what would have happened if the seeds did not spread and remain at one place only. We, human beings, also carry seeds from one place to another. Knowingly or unknowingly, we bring seeds of plants that we find beautiful or useful to grow them in our garden. Later, the seeds of these plants spread to another places. Many years later, people may not even remember that these plants did not grow here earlier. They were brought from somewhere else. Do you know from where chilies came to our country? These were brought to India by traders coming from South America. Today, we cannot think of food without chilies. Like chilies, cabbage was brought from Europe, tea, coffee from Africa, and our most favorite fruit, cashew, from Brazil. So many fruits were brought from other parts of the world. Trees and plants gives us so many things. How trees are useful for us, let's see. 1. Trees provides shade and keeps temperature cool. It is home to different birds and insects. Next, it gives us fruits to eat, medicine to cure, take in carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen, which is necessary and important for life. It have a big role in bringing rain. Without trees, environment may lose its control. We use as furniture in house, school, offices, garden, so on and so far. We use as a fire at the same time. So these are the several uses of tree, and without tree, we can't expect the life in this world. That's all about your lesson, seeds and seeds. What have we learned in this lesson? We learn about what are seeds, what are the types of seeds, what are the parts of seeds, what are sprouts, what is a process called sprouting, how sprouts are useful for the health of an individual, and above all, how a small, tiny, little seed grow into a big plant, and how these plants are useful in maintaining equilibrium in the ecosystem. That's all about our lesson, Seeds and Seeds. Next, we are coming up with more interesting topics from Environmental Studies 5th Standard. And for that matter, I request you all to stay tuned for the coming classes. Thank you very much and bye-bye.